Hi there, welcome! Let's see how to install your favorite plugins in FL Studio 11. Leave comments if you notice mistakes in our English. If you don't know, a plugin or VST is a piece of software that can be integrated inside another software, FL Studio in our case. In this way you can add extra effects and tools besides the ones you already have, giving you the possibility to edit your project even more deeply. Installing a VST may be complex, since they can have or not a setup installer, or can stop working if you move them elsewhere in your hard drive. But there is a way that can work with the majority of VSTs in a simple way. Before going on, you mustn't confuse 32-bit plugins with 64-bit ones. They give you the same effects and tools, but they may not work if you don't have the right operative system. In fact, 32-bit plugins work on both 32-bit and 64-bit systems, but 64-bit ones work just on 64-bit operative systems. Make sure to match the right bits before installing a plugin. Then, some plugins may have a setup or not, but all of them have a .dll file with the plugin name in most cases. It's this the file you have to include in FL Studio. It may be alone in simple plugins, or it is installed separately in bigger ones. For example, let's pick Massive by Native Instruments. This has a setup that lets you save the plugin .dll file separately in a folder that you can decide freely. Let's call this plugin folder for simplicity. Make sure to never move the .dll file from its folder. If you made up an installation, moving the file may cause malfunctions to your plugin. To integrate it in FL Studio, simply go to Options and then to File Settings. In the middle, you have a section called the VST Plugins Extra Search Folder, used to tell FL Studio that you have extra plugins there. So simply click on the folder button and browse for the plugin folder that contains the .dll file interested, then exit. All you need to do now is to search for that plugin. A plugin can add extra instruments and or extra effects. To add the new instruments, go to Channels, add one, and then to More. At the bottom of the new window, you have Refresh. Use Fast Scan or Scan and Verify to add the new plugin in the list, indicated in red. Here it is in black, since the plugin has been already added in the past. Click on the small left square then. An F letter indicates that it is active and shown. Most of them add effects instead. In the effects list, on the right of the mixer, click on the left arrow, go to Select and then to More. Do the same as seen before. The plugin will appear in the list of effects, fully integrated. The plugin integrated will be listed as long as the VST Extra Search folder is saved. If you click on Clear, you will delete the link, and so you won't find your plugin anymore. So if you want to keep more than one plugin all integrated in your software, make sure to create your own VST folder where you will drop and install all plugin.dll files altogether. Place it where you like, in your desktop or even inside the FL Studio folder. Just fix it and then use that as a plugin folder for this current plugin and all the next ones in the future. Then save it as the VST extra folder in the options section. If you do so, all the plugins installed using that folder will be easily and fast added in FL Studio. You will just need to use the refresh button to add them in the lists. Thanks for watching this video. Check our show to discover more about FL Studio 11.